Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope you all are doing well. So today we are going to see. So children, let's begin with exercise 27B, that is of quadrilaterals. Now the first question given over here is, in a trapezium ABCD, side AB is parallel to DC and angle A and angle C is given. Now when angle A and angle C is given, children, we have to calculate angle D and we have to calculate angle B. So according to the properties of trapezium, angle A and angle D will be together a supplementary angle. Similarly, angle C and angle B are going to be a supplementary angle. So we will be able to calculate angle B and angle D using this property. So in order to calculate angle D and angle B, children, we'll have to use a variable. Because in a trapezium, angle A and angle D is equals to 180, so you will have to suppose some variable for angle D. So I have taken that variable to be X. Angle A plus angle D is equals to 180, so 78 plus X is equals to 180, X is equals to 102 that ways. Similarly, children, we'll calculate the other angle, that is angle B. Because right now I showed you in the figure, angle B and angle C will together be 180 degrees. So you will again take a variable for angle B. Let angle B be Y. So Y plus 120 is equals to 180, Y is equals to 60. So this is how you calculate angle B and angle D. Coming to question number 2, children, again it is a trapezium ABCD where AB is parallel to DC. Now you can look at this figure only and understand that AB is parallel to CD, a similar kind of a figure, children, where angle A is given as X and angle D is given as 3X minus 20. We have to calculate the value of X. So again, using the same property, children, the sum of angle A and angle D will be 180. We will make use of that property. So I have written angle A plus angle D is equals to 180. Now substitute whatever other values of the angles given. X plus 3X minus 20 is equals to 180. Now because X and X are the like terms, so they can be added. 4X minus 20 is equals to 180. Now this 20 will be taken on the other side, will become plus. 4X is equals to 200. X is equals to 200 upon 4, which can be reduced by 4 to be 50. So the value of X is 50. In question number 3, children, the four angles of a quadrilateral are given as angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. And the ratio between the four is 3 is to 4 is to 5 is to 6. We have to calculate the value of all the four angles. So because they are in ratio, children, you will have to make use of a variable with this. So I have written, let the angles be 3x, 4x, 5x and 6x. Add these all four, should be equal to 360, because these are all like terms, so you can add or subtract according to the sign. So 18x after adding them is equals to 18x is equals to 360, x is equals to 360 upon 18. Now by 18 when I reduce, it comes out to be 20. So the value of x is how much, children? 20. Now put the value of x in all the four angles, so 3x, 4x, 5x and 6x can be calculated by this. So the angles are, children, 60, 80, 100 and 120. Now there is one more part of it. They want to know whether it forms a trapezium, and if it forms a trapezium, children, what are the parallel sides? Now for doing this, children, you will have to look at the various angles. The value of angle A, B, C and D are these. Now when we have the value of angle A, B, C and D, and when you draw any figure, children, suppose I draw any rough hand figure like this and I give them the names as A, B, C and D, children. Now this angle, that is A, is 60 and my D is 120. Together they are forming a 180 degree angle. Similarly, my C has come out to be 100, children, and my B is 80. Again, they are forming a 180 degree angle in between them. That means this side is running parallel to this side. Question number 5. Two diagonals of an isosceles trapezium are X and 3X minus 8. Find the value of X. Now, in two diagonals in an isosceles trapezium, children, they are always of the equal length. So we just have to equalize both these to get the value of X. So here's the working. As in an isosceles trapezium, the length of the diagonals is same. So we have written the measurement of the two diagonals on both the sides. Now bring the like terms together. Now this is a minus 8, children. Bring it on the other side of is equals to, it will become a plus 8. 3x and this plus x when goes on the other side becomes minus x. So 8 is equals to 2x, children. X is equals to 8 upon 2, and now I can reduce them by 2, so it is 4. So the value of x is equals to 4. Coming to question number 6, children. Angle A of an isosceles trapezium ABCD is 115. Find the angles BCD. Now this is the figure, children. It is an isosceles trapezium. And angle A is given. Now where is angle A? Here is angle A. It is given as 115 degrees. Now according to the properties of an isosceles trapezium, children, opposite angles are same. So if the A is 115, similarly C is also 115. And A and D together will form a supplementary angle. So from 180, if I subtract 150, I get D as 65. Similarly, D and B are opposite angles which are of same magnitude. So this is also a 65 degree angle. So this is how you calculate the four angles, the other three angles that are missing of a isosceles trapezium. A similar kind of a question is question number 7, children. Only thing is, now this is a parallelogram. Two opposite angles of a parallelogram are 100 each. Find the measure of the two opposite angles. Now we know in a parallelogram, children, also the adjacent angles will be 180 degrees. So according to that, you can take a variable and you can calculate that the missing angle is 80 and the opposite angle will also be 80. Or another way is, children, we know that in a quadrilateral, the sum of the interior angles is 360. Two angles are given of 100-100 each. So from 360, if you subtract 200, we are left with 160. And the other two angles, it is saying the other two opposite angles are of equal magnitude. So divide 160 by 2, you again get 80-80 degree angle each. Question number 8 is very simple, children. It says two adjacent angles of a parallelogram are 70 and 110 given. Find the measure of the other two angles. Now look at the figure, children. Because this is a parallelogram, so the opposite angles are of equal magnitude. If this is a 70 degree angle, this one over here is 70. And this is 110, so this one over here is also 110 degrees angle. Question number 9 is, the angles ABCD of a quadrilateral are in the ratio 2:3, again 2:3. We have to find all the angles. It is very simple, children. You will have to use a variable and then you can calculate all the four angles. Question number 10 is, in a parallelogram ABCD, its diagonal AC and BD are intersecting at each point. If AC is 12 and BD is 9, AC is 12, children. This whole length is 12. We have to tell the length of this. Now, whatever is the whole length, children, the center point, from the center point where they are intersecting, from there the length of the diagonal gets divided into two halves. So if AC is 12, children, divided by 2, it will give you the length of AO, which is 6. Similarly, children, if BD is equals to 9, the length of BO will be half of it, divided by 2 again, that is 4.5 centimeter. Coming to the next question, children. In a parallelogram ABCD, its diagonal intersect at point O. Now OA and OB is given. Now look at OA, children. OA and OB is given. And they want us to calculate the length of the complete diagonals. So whatever is OA multiplied by 2 will give you the length of AC. And whatever is OB multiplied by 2 will give you the length of B. Coming to question number 13, children. One diagonal of a rectangle is 18 centimeters. What is the length of the other diagonal? The length of the other diagonal will also be 18 centimeters because in a rectangle, the length of the two diagonals is same. Next is question number 14. Each angle of a quadrilateral is x plus 5. Find the value of x and each angle of a quadrilateral. Now over here the figure is all the four angles are given as x plus 5. So let's see the working. So I have written the sum of the four angles is 360. So write all the four angles is equals to 360. Open the bracket and bring the like terms together. All the like terms can be added. So 4x plus 20 is equals to 360. 4x is equals to 360 minus 20. 4x is equals to 340. x is 340 divided by 4, and now this can be reduced by 4 itself, 85. So the value of x is 85. Now each angle we have to calculate, each angle is x plus 5, so 85 plus 5 is 90 degree. So in case the figure is a quadrilateral and has all the four angles as 90 degrees, so that figure is a rectangle. Question number 15. If three angles of a quadrilateral are 90 degree each, show that the given quadrilateral is a rectangle. Now, if I add the three 90 degree angle children, it will be 270. And from 360, when we subtract 270, again we get a 90 degree. That means all the four angles of a quadrilateral are 90. And thus we can say that the given quadrilateral is a rectangle. The diagonals of a rhombus are 6 and 8 centimeters. State the type of angle they will make when they intersect. Children, whether it is any kind of a diagonal, whenever they are going to bisect each other, they are going to come and meet each other, they will always form a 90 degree angle in between. Write giving reason the name of the figure drawn alongside and under what condition will this be a square. Now look at the figure, children. The two sides are all running parallel to each other first, and second is the measurements are same of all the four sides. This is 6, 6, 6 and 6. So when we have the same measurement of all sides and they are running parallel to each other, the given figure is a rhombus. It can be a square, children, if the angles, the four angles are 90 each. Then in that case, the figure can be said to be a square. So with this, we come to an end of this exercise. I hope I made myself very clear. Thank you. I hope, children, after seeing the entire video and after listening to me very carefully, you have understood each and everything that I have tried to explain you. Now, if you have really understood the lesson well, don't forget to please subscribe, like, and do share my videos with many of your friends so that they also are being helped by me, that is Mrs. D. Nandan. So, thank you and have a wonderful day ahead. Bye-bye.